अप्राप्य मृत्यु संसार वत्मनि मृत्यु संसार वत्मनि अप्राप्य मांग निवर्तन्ति मृत्यु संसार वत्मनि अश्वद्धान पुरुषा धर्मशास परंतप मृत्यु संसार वर्त्मने अश्वद्धाना दोज हु आर फेथलेस So those who are faithless means anyone can understand those who do not believe in the words of God, they are faithless. Just like a child by nature, he has to believe his parents, his superiors, his teacher. But if he does not believe in the words of the superior, then where is the possibility of education? There is no question. This is the first qualification. If you go to your teacher to learn ABCD, the teacher says, my dear child, you begin from the left side in this way. Then if the student says, why shall I begin in this way? I shall begin this way. Then he is faithless. He cannot make any progress. It is not possible. The first qualification is saddhadhana, faithful. If you go to a teacher, you must be faithful. Otherwise, there is no need of going to a teacher. If you cannot believe in the words of somebody whom you are going to appoint as your teacher, if you have no faith in his word, then what is the use of going to such teacher? There is no use. Don't waste your time and don't waste his time. Therefore, those who are going to learn to become a disciple or teacher, he must believe in the words of teacher. Or if you are doubtful, you should not go to such teacher. This is first qualification. If you do not believe somebody, then you find out someone else upon whom you can put your faith. Yes, here is the right man who can teach me. Otherwise, there is no use of going to a teacher. This is the Vedic principle. The Vedic principle is everyone is in ignorance. Because the evolution is coming from the lower species of life. And in Western countries, the Darwin's theory of evolution is very prominent, and they believe that man is coming from monkey. Of course, the Vedic Shastra also says the birth of human being are from three sources. One from the cow, the other from the lion, and the other from the monkey. The monkey word is there. Those who are coming in the satogon, modes of goodness, their last birth is as cow. And those who are coming through the rajogon, their last birth is lion. And those who are coming through the tamogon, their last birth is monkey. We have explained many times that they are the lower animals, less than the human being. There are 8 million forms. Jalayana Ulakkani Savara Lokkaminsati Krimaya Rudra Sankhaka Pakshinam Dasalakkakam Tinsalakshani Pasaba Chaturlakkani Manasa. This is the least of evolution. Darwin has taken, but he has explained in a different way, misguiding way. But anyway, the evolution theory, it is not theory, it is fact, that is acceptable by the Vedic scholar also. It is explained in the Padma Purana, asutin chaturang saiva lakhan sthan jiva jatisu. This is the statement in the Padma Purana, that the asitin chaturang saiva, 8,400,000. They say in the Vedic language, 4,800,000, 8,400,000. Anyway, the evolution is there, and in the lower species of life, there are 8 million human forms of life, only 400,000, out of which more than 300,000 forms of life are uncivilized men. They do not know what is the aim of life. The best form of human life, the Aryans. Aryans means those who are advanced. So, the Aryan family, the history of Aryan family from Central Asia, Caucasian ranges, divided, the Indo-Aryans, Indo-Europeans, this is the history of mankind. So, the Europeans, they belong to the Indo-Europeans, and some of the Europeans, not the uncivilized, the civilized, they came from that side, eastern side, when there was a threatening by Parshuram to kill the Kshatriyas. So most of the Kshatriyas, they came to Europe, and some of them settled in the middle, in the border of Europe and Asia, Turkey, Greece. There is a big history, Mahabharata. Mahabharata means the greater history of India. So, on the whole, the conclusion is that the Aryans spread in Europe also, and the Americans, they also spread from Europe. So, the intelligent class of human being, they belong to the Aryans, Aryan family. Just like Hitler claimed that he belonged to the Aryan family. Of course, they belong to the heavier Aryan families. So, there is gradual process of evolution, and the human form of life is the greatest evolution. Here is a junction. Now you can go elevate yourself to further higher status of living condition that is called devata or demigods. Urdhaṁ gacchanti sattvasthva. If you develop the quality of goodness, then you are promoted to the higher planetary system. Urdhaṁ gacchanti sattvasthva. Madhye tisthanti rājasa. If you do not develop further, if you remain whatever quality of God, just now you remain within this world, and adho gacchanti tamasa, and if you do not develop goodness or remain in the same quality, but you degrade yourself, then again go to the cycle of birth in the animal kingdom. This is the law of nature. Urdhaṁ gacchanti sattvasthva, madhye tisthanti rājasa, jaghanna gunavittistha, adho gacchanti tamasa. Jaghanna gunavittistha. Jaghanna means abominable. Abominable, without any distinction. Whatever I like, I shall do. No, you cannot do that. You have got now super consciousness. You must decide whether you want to stop this evolutionary process, cycle of birth and death, and go back to home, back to Godhead. Or if you want to continue again the cycle of birth and death, that is up to you to decide. This is the human form of life. Therefore, how you can promote yourself to the higher status of life, or how you can degrade yourself to the lower status of life, that is to be decided. In the Bhagavad Gita you will find, jānti deva vrata devān pitrīn jānti pitrini vrata bhūte ja jānti bhūtāni mad jājinopi jānti mām. There are four ways suggested. If you want to go to the higher planetary system, not by force you can go to the moon planet. That is not possible. That is simply childish. You cannot go. You must have to be qualified how to go there. Just like if somebody comes to your country, Australia, he has to take the visa, permit, passport, so many things. Then you allow. So how you can be allowed to enter into the moon planet, which is the residential place of demigods? That is a very controversial point. They say that they have gone to moon planet and there is no life. This is simply nonsense. Every planet is full of living entities. But if they say they could not find any living entity, then it is to be understood they haven't gone to the moon planet. There are many other points also we do not wish to discuss. But moon planet is the higher planetary system, sun planet is the higher planetary system, and there are many others. If you like to go there, you can go. Jānti deva vrata devān, you have to prepare yourself for going there. Similarly, there are pitri lokas, you can see so many, many thousands and millions of planets. Every planet is residential quarter. Just like this planet is residential quarter, every planet is residential. Innumerable lives there are according to the position. So, here it is said that asvaddhana purusha. Krishna is giving a system as you can go to him. Back to home, back to God. That is Krishna consciousness movement. Why one should go to God? That is stated in the Bhagavad Gita. Jadgatyana nivartante tad dhamam paramam mama. You can go to any other planet, you can have very long duration of life. The standard of living is very, very high. Just like here in this planet, sometimes we see the standard of living condition in Europe, America is better than other places, and they become very much clever that in Europe and America, and Australia is also another edition of European. So big, big roads, big, big skyscraper house are very comfortable. So as we see differences of standard of living here, similarly, each and every planet, there is different standard of living. And it is said in the Shastra that if you go to the moon planet, then you live there for 10,000s of years. 10,000 of years, and their calculation of time is also greater than ours. It is calculated that our 6 months is equal to their one day. That is called Deva calculation. In this way, you can get very long duration of life, very comforts, nice, beautiful body and residential quarters. Everything is very, very nice. Each higher planetary system is better than the other, better than the other. In this way, you can go to the Brahmaloka. Brahmaloka means where the topmost planet. They have calculated, modern astronomers and the planet was that it takes about 40,000 of years to go to the topmost planet of this universe. These things are there. Anyway, in Bhagavad Gita, it is saying that even if you go to the topmost planet, there is also birth, death, old age and disease. You cannot avoid this. So long you shall remain within this material world, you have to accept these four principles of material condition that you will have to die. Either you live for 10,000s of years or 10 millions of years, it doesn't matter, you have to die. Even Brahma dies, who has got many millions of years. It is stated in the Bhagavad Gita, Brahma's one day daytime duration, which is calculated our 12 hours. Because 12 hours day, 12 hours night, that is 24 hours. So Brahma's one daytime duration, 12 hours, is calculated to be 4,300,000 of years multiplied by 1,000. Now calculate, what is it? That is 4,300,000 of years. 4,300,000 years or something like that. That is our, as our 12 hours, Brahma's 12 hours is that. Then add 12 hours again, 400,000,000,000 years, that means altogether 8 billions of years, that is one day, Brahma. Then calculate 1 month, then calculate 1 year, such 100 years he lives. So that is stated in the Bhagavad Gita. Sahasra yuga parjantam marahajyat brahmano vidu. Sahasra yuga parjantam. One yuga means 43 lakhs of, 100,000 of years. Sahasra means 1,000 times. That is, everything is stated there. You can learn, you can understand. So that is called Brahmaloka. And it is also stated, Abrahma bhavana lokan punaravartin arjuna. Even if you reach to the Brahmaloka, you can get long duration of life, there is no doubt. But again, punaravartina, you have to die and you have to go to another body and another planet. But I am eternal. We are eternal. Nahannate hannavane sarire. by destruction of this body, maybe after 2 hours or 4 minutes, there are many living entities. They live for some minutes, some seconds, some years. The human in this material world, in this planetary system, we live, say, at most 100 years. But in other planetary system, they live for millions of years. It is, of course, the world is relative. According to your position, the relative condition is there. My past and present and future is not the same past, present, future of an ant. The ant's past fusion may be 3 hours or 4 hours. Our past present means 100 hours, and Brahma's past present millions of years. Everything is relative according to the position. So, real aim of life is to stop the cycle of birth and death. That is real aim of life. If we do not know this, then we are ignorant. We are ignorant. First of all, we must know that I am eternal. That is, in the beginning of the Bhagavad Gita, it is very nicely explained that antavattu ime deha nitya sukta sharirina. My dear Arjuna, this body is destructive. But the proprietor of the body, he is eternal. That is the first step. I am not this body. I am the proprietor of this body. You are not this body. You are the proprietor of this body. But if we think that I am body, then that is the same thing as the dog is thinking. Therefore I have given in this statement that if we think this lump of matter as myself, then we are no better than the dog. The dog is also thinking like that. That human form of life is meant for understanding that I am not this lump of butter, matter. I am aham brahmasmi. I am spirit soul. That is required. The whole Bhagavad Gita teaching is based on this principle. First of all, to understand that I am not this body. I am spirit soul. Brahma, aham brahmasmi. Brahma bhuta prasannatma nasotati nakankati. Samasarveshu bhuteshu madhvakti labati para. If from this material conception of life, somehow or other, you come to the understanding that you are not this body, lump of matter, you are spirit soul, you are different from this body, that is called Brahma-bhuta state. And as soon as you become on the Brahma-bhuta status, then symptom will be nasochati prasannātmā. You become happy immediately. Everyone is unhappy in this material world. That's a fact. And why you are unhappy? Because we have accepted, misaccepted, wrongly accepted this body, myself. This is the defect of modern civilization. So long you do not understand that you are not this body, you are different from this body, you are Brahma, you are part and parcel of God, then your activities become different. Because at the present moment, we are acting on the bodily concept of life. I am American, I am Indian, I am Australian, I am white, I am black, I am Brahman, I am Sudra, I am this, that. Only this bodily concept of life. And the Krishna consciousness begins when you are free from this bodily conception of life. That is called Brahma-bhuta. Brahma-bhuta prasannātmā na sochati na kāṅkhati samas sarveshu bhūteshu madhbhakti labhati parām. Bhakti, this activity begins when you are Brahma-bhuta. Now what is the symptom of becoming Brahma-bhuta? That is stated, prasannātmā, happiness, only happiness. There is no question of distress. That is Brahma Bhuta. You cannot say, now I have become Brahma realized, Brahma Bhuta, but I am crying for cigarette. No. Immediately, test. So you cannot be unhappy. I am not this thing, that thing. Because here we are creating wants. Kankhati. This material symbolism means simply creating wants. That's all. Big want or small want, that is called kankhati. And another counterpart of this material life is whatever you have got, if it is lost, then you cry. One side is you are hankering after something which you do not possess. And if your possession is lost, then you cry for the loss. This is two business. Kankhati, sochati. But if you become Brahma Bhuta, self-realized, these two things will be absent immediately. Na sochati, na kankhati. Samas sarvesu bhuteshu. Now there is racial animosity all over the world. You are American, you are Russian, you are Indian, you are Chinese, you are Pakistani, Israel. They are fighting, going on this understanding. We are Chinese, we are Americans, we are Russians. So when you come to the platform of nasochati, not identifying with this body, then samas sarvesu bhuteshu. You see everyone on the same platform. You do not see here is a Chinese or American or Australian. You see a soul is entrapped in a material body. So material body is lump of matter. We are concerned with the spirit soul. Then samas sarvesu bhuteshu. Pandita samadarshina. One who is learned, Pandit, he is samadarshan. He has no more this vision that here is an American, just like in our society, you'll find. People from all parts of the world. There are Americans, there are Indians, there are Africans, Canadians, Japanese. But we don't feel like that. I am Japanese, I am Indian, I am American. We all feel servant of Krishna. This is Krishna consciousness. This is United Nation. Not that going to the United Nation and barking like the dog. I am American, I am Indian, I am seeing, I am that. What is the benefit? Therefore they are barking for the last 20, 30 years. What benefit has come? You cannot make the dogs, you bring some dogs from America and from Australia and from India and put them together and ask them, please live very peacefully. If you keep them as dogs, they will simply bark. There will be no more peace. Just try to understand, practically. You have to make them human beings. If you keep them dogs and cats, there cannot be any peace. This is really knowledge. The Krishna consciousness movement is giving such knowledge that they will never remain a dog or cat, they will become actual human beings. This is Krishna consciousness. Therefore it is said, asaddhana purusha. Those who have not faith in this process of understanding Krishna consciousness, asaddhana purusha dharmasya asya. Now this is real dharma. Dharma means occupation. I have explained yesterday. I am servant of God. This is my real occupation. But giving up my service to God, I am giving service to Maya. Therefore, I am servant of my senses, my family, my society, my country, my nation, and if I haven't got to serve anybody, then I keep one dog, I become a servant of the dog. And somebody was just telling me that in Japan, the dog passes through and the master collects it and puts it somewhere. Yes. Oh, this is going on. Your position is to become servant. But in Maya, in illusion, you are thinking I am master. Therefore, the best thing is that instead of becoming at last the servant of a dog, just immediately become servant of God. That is your success of life. And if you don't agree, then you have to serve up to the dog, up to the cat. Many Europeans, Americans, they have no children, but they keep one cat, one dog to serve. You see? But you have to serve, because you are meant for that. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's philosophy is that Jiver Sarupa Nitya Krishna Das. That is our permanent situation. We are servant of God. I have explained yesterday that we are part and parcel of God. Now, as part and parcel of God, what is our duty? The example I have given, just like the finger, is the part and parcel of my body. So what is the duty? As soon as I say, finger, please come here, it comes. Finger, come here. Do this, do that, pick up. This is finger's business. A finger cannot remain independent. Or if the finger cannot give the service properly, then it is disease. Similarly, our material condition means we are in disease condition. We are not giving service to God, we are giving service to the dog. This is our disease condition. So, God is Himself explaining how you should live. That is Bhagavad Gita. Therefore it is said, asaddhana purusha dharma sasa parantapa. My dear Arjuna, if somebody has no faith in my words, then what will be the result? The result will be aprapama. He will not get me. Aprapa means not getting myself. Then what he will get? Aprapama nivartante. Again he goes back. Instead of going back to home, back to Godhead, he goes back to where? Na mrityu sansara vartmani. Again in the cycle of birth and death. Again cycle of birth. Suppose this human form of life, you can make your life so perfect that immediately after death, after giving up this body, you go back to home, back to God. You regain your eternal life. But if you misuse this human form of life, do not endeavor for going back to home, back to God, then again go back to the cycle of birth and death. This is nature's work. You are not independent. Nature is working like that. Prakite kriyamanani gunai karmani sarvasa ahankara vimunatma kartaham iti manyate. You are thinking foolishly as a rascal that you are independent. You are not independent. You are completely under the control of material nature. Now, in this human form of life, there are two ways. You go back to home, back to Godhead, or go back to again to become a pig, hog, and tree, and plant. This is the plan of Bhagavad Gita. Thank you very much. Hitler or anyone, if he does not take advantage of this human form of life for going back to home, back to Godhead, he will be put into, again, in the cycle of birth, maybe different forms of birth.
I have another question. You were talking about the planets, the planetary system. The planets in our solar system, are they in the middle planetary systems or the lower planetary systems?
What is the question about planetary
system? This planet, where is it situated in the planetary system?
You cannot understand it. The whole planetary system is just like a big tree, and there are many fruits. So here, this planet planet is one of the fruits of the planetary system.
The planets in our solar system are
it. Yeah. Astrology. Astronomy. That is planetary system. It is the basic system. You can see at night the whole planetary system is moving like this. Bunch of tree. And in Bhagavad Gita it is said, urdhamulam adhosaka. This, it is just like a big tree, and the root is upwards, and the branches and fruits downwards. This is the pole star is the center of this root of this planetary system. So if you read our books, fifth canto, Srimad Bhagavatam, you will get full description.
Talking about the higher planets?
Yes. Don't you see a higher planet system?
The
sun planet, the moon planet, they are not higher on your top. There are many others, millions. These are prominent. According to Vedic system, the moon planet is higher than the sun planet. So these descriptions are there in the fifth canto. I shall request you to read them to understand.
Srila Prabhupada, Krishna is perfect and complete in himself, so why are there the individual minute living entities? If Krishna is perfect, surely there would be no need for a smaller living entity.
What is that?
Krishna is perfect and complete, and why does he need little entities like us?
I call that why his son becomes a loafer.
If there's a high court judge and he has a son, why does the son sometimes become a loafer?
Is it guaranteed that because one is son of high court judge, he will also become a high court judge? There is no such guarantee. Everyone is individual. We are sons of God, that's all right. But we have got little independence. If we misuse our independence, then we become Lord. Krishna is perfect, there is no doubt. But we are part and parcel. Just like another example. There is a fire. And there are sparks of fire. The sparks are very little, small fire particles. Sometimes they fall down from the fire and it becomes extinguished. The fiery quality is lost. Similarly, we are all parts and parcel of God. But when, by misusing our intelligence, our independence, we come here in this material world to enjoy, our godly qualities become lost. Again, if we revive, then you go back to home, back to God. The Krishna consciousness movement is to help people. How to revive is God consciousness. Again goes back to home, back to God. Tattade hang punarjanmanaiti mameti kohanti. It is clearly said. If simply one tries to understand what is Krishna or God, and if he actually understands, then after giving up this body, he is no more going to accept any material body. He goes back to home, back to God. Why don't you try for them? Try to understand Krishna. Krishna is explaining himself. You take this Bhagavad Gita as it is and read it regularly, you will understand Krishna, your life is successful. You have asked one question. Any more? What is your question?
What is the purpose of so many nationalities on this earth?
What is that?
What is the purpose of so many nationalities?
If I say, I already said, dog is mentality. That's all. He remained dog, go on barking. That's all. What is the national? I'm American, I have my first interest, my time, I'm Australian, I'm Indian, I'm Pakistan. They are black barking in Indian tradition, that's all. This is the benefit. Bark and die like dog, that's all. Better chant Hare Krishna.
Yeah.
All right, chant Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.